Hello, and welcome back to the Saving Sephardic series in CK2, Monks and Mystics Expansion. So, we're in the middle of a crusade, and then we finally, will be able to install our head of religion. So, let's get started. So, we're going to split this army up, because we're taking some bad attrition here, and that is not fun. So let's go and get leaders in charge, and attack these Knights of Santiago. Listen, you're never going to get Hispania. They just don't understand. Meanwhile, we're going to keep this money in reserve instead of upgrading holdings. Just in case. But yeah. I think this campaign's going pretty well. Looking forward to getting the head of religion and going on our first... is it called the Great Holy War? If it's a Jewish one? I think it is. It's not technically a crusade. But we're gonna call it a crusade, so yeah, it's a crusade. But yeah, and we have this, he's Jewish now. Why is his... barony is Germanic and not under us. And the city. Very strange. It's an odd area. It's all mixed up in Norwegian and such. But yeah, I streamed for the first time yesterday, which I was very happy about. Successfully, that is. Yeah, if you ever see me streaming, I'm at Guizarm, the same name at Twitch as I am on YouTube. And yeah, it's a lot of fun. Got to talk to some people, answer some questions. It was cool. Stop my horse. My first series, the Hindustan, Jaunpur into Hindustan, in EU4 on stream. So yeah, if you want to check it out, come on by. But let's get back into this game. We are crushing them. 66% war score. It's a slow roll. We can go and kill off any of these people? Nope. They're too fast. And it looks like we kind of took the strength out of the Catholics. They're kind of just throwing in 1,000-man armies. It's pretty weak. A little pathetic, let's be real. Yeah, we'll be a hunter. Absolutely. That's sweet. What is it? It's probably Marshall. Oh wait, we didn't become a... Yes, we did. Sweet, 2 Marshall, 1 Diplomacy, Pursuit plus 20%, and same trait modifier. It's pretty good. You go along the coast there. We've got more Knights of Santiago. Yep. So let's go wipe them out quick. And sure, I guess you can siege. Go ahead. Which, yeah, let's just wait here. Wait for him to land. Or end up in this Asturias. Remember when we were just these two provinces? That was the day. Yeah, this has been a really fun series. I think it's the Sephardic cultures. Just Hispania, because everybody else has Ashkenazi, I'm pretty sure, when they get that pop-up where a Jewish courtier arrives. So I'm pretty sure it's only Hispania, which is, I think makes this series pretty cool, and made it pretty fun for me. Alright, let's go intrigue, kill off some men. Argument is resolved. Proofs of justice. Okay, cool. Meanwhile, these men, you should be attacking them. You have commanders in charge, good. 6,000 men in the forest. We can take them. And this is sieged by rebels. Okay. So can't do anything about them. Oh, come on. Man, they're always faster than me. I wonder if they just have like more. I'm not sure what determines the speed of the army, except for organizer trait. In CK2. I wonder if troop composition matters. Gains diligence or gains just. You'll be diligent. We should get a chancellor. And then, who has siege down? So, someone sieged that down. So let's go and rectify that. Okay. Get money. In Porto. Nope. God, I really hate that. That little interaction right there, where you click, you're trying to assign someone, but you already have a. Because, I mean, you're always usually assigning people to your capital, multiple people. So then you click on your other advisor and it gets you out of the screen. Little UI thing, but it's annoying. Okay, you're just gonna go to assault. Anyway, 83% war score, not too long now. And then we're gonna have a time of peace, where we are going to slowly wait for our threat to go down. Speaking of which, we should be making sure. Yes, you are working on perform statecraft for that threat decay minus 16, or plus 16% threat decay, yes. Who? Oh, come on. It's a weak holding, so they keep sieging down in like a day. Okay, siege back. 86%. And we'll kill you for your insolence. Let's get the King of Mauritania. He'll not actually be. Oh, he is malcontent, despite that. What are you angry about? Let's see. Wants control of the Duchy of Fez. Well, that seems like a totally reasonable request. Ta-da! And we're good. And now he's no longer probably discontent. Malcontent. Hopefully, he'll change. Anyway. If not, one having one malcontent on your council isn't the worst idea. If it makes their opinion of you better. Alright. Court position, let's appoint one. That man. Stop sieging down my landings, my holdings. Oh, that is more men than I thought there would be, but okay. I think we're gonna win anyways. Yep. One of our commanders died in the process, though, which is too bad. And we can get tolerance up, so let's get a. Full status of woman, and then military organization, we'll get that up, and we will see how many horses we can make. Speaking of which, let's so we can, but let's not do it right now. And then let's see, let's pass the law. Full status of woman, supporters, a lot of them. Okay. Saddle my horse. Okay, stop sieging down Perigord. We're at 90% war score, pretty much. Let's go watch prisoners from the Holy Order. What's that Holy Order? Knights of Calatrava. I'm starting to get their flags down. The Catholic Holy Orders have such cool flags, though, I have to say. You know, like the. They're just nice and simple. But cool, anyway. So yeah, I like them. We'll see what the zealots are, because I believe that's what the Jewish holy order is called, the zealots. It reminds me of StarCraft. We will become lustful. No, I shouldn't. Won't give up. Good. And let's go to let's go. To restock in Navarre. Meanwhile, you, my good man. Well, first, we're going to. My brave knights have captured the target of the crusade. What is. Excellent. Okay, that was weird. Fate smiles upon me. My wife, Saris, is pregnant. Alright. And let's appoint some commanders and then deal with that 6,000 stack. Nope, we don't want that. That was incorrect. King of Aquitaine, sure, we're fine with killing you off. And we can now have female leaders, which is cool. I think, because it didn't pass. Yes, it did. Cool. We are such an enlightened society. I'm just going to pat myself on the back a little bit. Okay, let's get some commanders in charge. You and you. And these are the Knights Hospitalier, and yeah. And we are almost done with this war. My gosh, do these crusades drag on when you're defending? I really wish there's something you could. Maybe if we went and siege down the Pope. That'd be fun, but I don't think it's worth it for the attrition that we're gonna take along the way. Okay, killed all Plot's men. Continue killing off more men. 92%. We're making it. 1,000 man army killed at the time. Speaking of which, are they? They are not sieging down anything. Not real imaginative, they're army planners. No, like, behind the back attempts or naval landings. Just, you know, full frontal assault and lose. Do not use the information against him. We're a lenient kind of ruler. Let's go to here. Ooh, and we have a 5,000 Pope stack, so let's go and get it, and I think that will be the end of the war, hopefully. The English are like, oh crap. Maybe that wasn't the best idea to stick around with the Pope. You're hiding away from disease. Okay. And 3,000 men turn to dust. Good intrigue, good. And that's the war. Thank you for the money, that will pay for many of my horses. Pathetic. Alright. Let's see, pick an ambition, what can we do? Yes, we will see the Robin prosper. Because I don't think we're going to be doing much warring in the next couple, I don't know what to call them. Years, yeah, probably years. And then let's lower down to troops. What is this? Celebrate Passover? Sure. For that plus 10 modifier with all your vassals, I will absolutely celebrate Passover. Okay, let's group up all of the retinue in Toledo. Of course, man, as our empire grows, it's a whole lot of people that don't want to be passing the Matzo. Next year in Jerusalem, which is kind of weird, seeing as we have Jerusalem, but I guess we don't have the Holy Land yet. Maybe that'll change. That'd be cool to see if that changes when we create Israel. Ask about press claims. Peace be with you. I request that you repay the favor you owe me by declaring a de jure claim on Dharam against Caliph Farouk. Is this Desert Dharam? Who is he? He's in the defensive pact. Well, let's see what would happen if we declared the shore war. Everybody would join. Sorry, bud. Can't really do that one. I mean, it's like, excuse me, but I'd like you to pay my favor. I'd like you to commit suicide. Yeah, okay. Not gonna do that one. We'd have to face the two-front war with all the Christians, because we were at 52% threat. No, we're not gonna do that. No sirree. Idle council members, you can be training troops in here. And let's go to our retinue. Let's get as many horses as we can. Is that it? That's it. Okay. But 5 extra horses. That's another 1,250 men. And another 250 heavy Cav. Venetian politics. How is the trade going in this campaign? Let's see. Of course, Venice survives in the campaign that I'm not playing as them, but anyway. Just my little bit of bitterness. So it's Genoa and Venice that have survived. And they're not doing too great. Genoa's doing alright, but Venice is kind of weak at the moment. Yeah. Alright. And I'm assuming that... what? Where? You're not good at much. I'm assuming that Byzantines are still Bogomilist. See, we should be friends. Byzantines, you're feminist, we're feminist. It's all great. And by feminist, I mean like equal representation, blah, blah, blah. Sunborn. There we go. Keep this information to myself. 6,500. The Grand Tournament. It's a lot of men you have there, King of Mauritania. Well, you're also the Duke of Sevilla. How many men do you have? 12,000. It's not bad. Press claims. Okay, so let's see. What's our threat at? Oh my gosh. Yes, we do want to go to this war, but we don't want to do it before. What is gathering me of an ambitious adventurer, Bjorn, is gathering men for some sort of attack on my territory. Who is this guy? He's Catholic. I think of assassins. Let's see if we can kill him. No. Alright, we're just going to defend against that. Let's wait. Let's see if it goes to... okay. So defensive acts of other religious groups will not join against me. Alright. Let's do this, then. There we go. Are we immediately at war with you? Yes. Alright. Let's gather up the troops. One last fight for the Holy Land. It's gonna be a big one. But I don't believe that the Sunni Caliph is in this war. Yeah. In fact, he's at war with the Shias, I think. No. He's at war with that guy. Okay. So, let's raise up the troops and gather them all up. Okay, get everybody. And let's all meet in Alexandria. Probably should have watched out for that. Okay, so let's go around the problem area, and then go to Alexandria. With you, just keep going. And you don't go through there. Okay, that is everybody, I believe. Nope, who's still going through? You are. And you. Okay, just don't do that. It's like they want to get killed off. Alright. Poitou prospers. 1900 gold. It's too expensive. They always catch me at the worst times. I'd be fine going into debt if I wasn't at war. Then again, I mean, I'm like constantly at war, so maybe that's the problem. And maybe that says something about me. But this isn't the time for introspection. We're going for the Holy Land. Flamboyant schemer. Alright. Not exactly the greatest, but whatever. Create new house. And I think we're going to be able to just assault down holdings to get the this piece of the land. Once we get our men, of course. Which are all filing over, if I'm guessing correctly. Okay, you are going to be... yeah, might focused, I guess. Oh, but of course, you can be commanders now, so that's good. It's nice. So we should be raising everybody for to be military. Even the girls. And can we pass No, we cannot pass it. Inheritance law. Okay, there's the Egyptians. And there's the Syrians. But we're making our way over, slowly but surely. Making the long trek across North Africa. Okay, let's see. Yes, you will absolutely be military. Defeat, defeat. They're sieging on our holdings. Not cool. They got 30,000 over there. Okay, that's dangerous. And the Sunnis are in giant revolt. Interesting. Oh, and what's our force limits like nowadays? 46,000. Nice. So we can definitely group up a lot more men. Now that we got that military organization level. Okay, let's see. Okay, 17,000. Let's get you some commanders. And then you will go and kill off that stack. This time it will not escape me. Of course. We did successfully hunt down the white stag once this game. It's impressive. Okay, everybody's already accounted for. Let's go with you and you. Nope. And you. There we go. A perfect 10-10-10 across the board. Not exactly really perfect, but you know what I mean. Hey, actually, let's reinforce this fight. Doesn't seem to be going too well. Assemble the bomb? No. We'd rather have these, the trade posts in our land. Okay, it looks like we won the fight anyway. It's good to see. You are going to hunt down those men. Actually, no, you're gonna hunt down these men. How many men can go there? 21,000? No, actually, we're gonna hunt down those men. Take it back. Killed them off in their entirety. Good. Okay, let's siege us back. A wonderful idea, sure. Okay, let's kill off the more men. Taking some prisoners. Siege down the holdings back. And now let's go and deal with this major 17,000 stack army. And let's bring these guys up in support. Meanwhile, you will go and fight them in Cairo. Or wherever they want to go. Okay, they are running away. They do not want to fight us, which is a good sign. Probably because of our 1,250 heavy cav. It is an imposing sight. Let's go become charitable. Nope. And it looks like we are winning. Yes. Barely pulled that one out, but... And we lost more men than them, but we still won the fight. Where are you guys going? Beership. Yes. Okay, you guys are going to support. And go over to this stack. Let's get you going to... the target province. And then you will go and hunt down the stack. Okay. And Lombardy declared war on us, because why not? Alright, so let's see. How many troops do you have? Mr. Lombard. 24,000, not insignificant. But I think we'll be fine. Alright, so let's go. Let's group up on this guy. And then we turn back. Alright, So we're gonna siege down these forts. And then immediately send them in. Well, let's send them to here. And then all the way back to Valencia. Actually, what are you at war for? Tunis, okay. Of course you would do that. So let's go through there. And then all the way to Tunis. Alright. We are crushing this army. Good. Lass. All of our commanders are dying, of course. Did commanders actually die this much in battle in the Middle Ages? I mean, I know it was possible, but I thought that they like stayed a little bit more back than that. Anyway, let's go siege down this capital. Oh, and we got a 16,000 stack, so let's watch out for them. But they are just going down to the target province, I believe. So let's just, let's do this. Let's go to Damascus and we will assault down the fort. And that'll end the war. In one go. Excellent, he's a renowned physician. There we go. Okay, siege it down. 26 days for this next castle. Man, that lost a lot of men, but I think we can still siege it down. There we go. And they got there before us. Dang it. That was a bad idea. Thought we could have done it. Okay, men. You're coming back. No longer are you going to Tunis. We will deal with them afterwards. Okay, your job is to dodge this army. So let's go to... Where are you going? Tiberias? Okay, yes, continue going there. Go to Tyrus. She must learn on her own. Okay, you're delayed. Sneak by you. And siege down this province. Maybe we'll win this war after all, and without fighting him. Well, we already fought him, but fighting him again. 60%, 80%, 100%, and we got the province. Nice. Alright, so that's that. We can create Israel, even though we're at war. Yeah. The Promised Land. With Jerusalem and the Promised Land under Jewish control, the time is ripe for the creation of a new united monarchy named Israel, like the great kingdom of ancient times. Under David and Solomon, the long-suffering Jewish people are finally in control of their own destiny again. No longer shall the Holy Land be torn asunder by warring Christian and Muslim lords. May this new kingdom usher in the era of peace and prosperity for the region. Long live Israel. Emperor Sargon the Able is granted the Kingdom of Israel. Okay, so let's look at our kingdoms. So we still have the Empire of Hispania, the Kingdom of Asturias, and the Kingdom of Israel. So let's see if we can destroy the Kingdom of Asturias. And all de jure vassals in the Kingdom of Asturias, so quite a bit. It is primogeniture, so let's just keep all the kingdoms. It's fine. Or we could give you the Kingdom of Israel. Can't land a title. Kingdom of Israel. Include lower titles. No one. I think we're just going to keep it. But is there any other decisions? Restore the high priesthood. Okay, what does it say? The office of the Kohen Gadol, the high priest of Judaism, has been vacant since the destruction of the second temple in the hands of the Romans. Now that the third temple has been built, perhaps a new high priest should be appointed. The Kohen Gadol. There has not been a Kohen Gadol, a high priest of Judaism, roughly 1,000 years ago. At long last, this position has been filled and the high priesthood reconstituted. Like the Jewish priests of ancient times, the Kohen Gadol was traditionally required to be a descendant of Aaron, the older brother of Moses. Due to a lack of suitable candidates, this requirement has been waived, but the new high priest still enjoys the respect of the Jewish religious communities, and the priesthood has moved into the establishment itself at the Third Temple. Long live the Kohen Gadol. Alright, let's see if the Holy Orders come in to save us from the Lombards. Alright, let's go. And immediately, you are going to go to there. And you are going to go to... Let's go to Gabba's. And now this should be going down. And there we go, the Zealots. The third temple now stands tall on the Temple Mount in Jerusalem, and several pious Jews have formed a new holy order modeled after the ancient Zealots to protect Judaism against its enemies. Just like the Jewish sect that is their namesake, these new Zealots will not shy away from violence against those they feel are deserving. Some within the Jewish religious community have accused the Zealots of taking their faith to the extreme levels, but the ranks of the new order continue to swell as Jewish exiles returning to the Promised Land flock to their banner. Their numbers now include everyone from uneducated peasants to veteran soldiers from distant European wars. Any defense of Judaism is welcome. Nice. So let's immediately go to this holy order. Go to the lead. Offer vassalization. No. Not my dear liege. That's 5. Another 5. And then 3. So 13, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So let's... Can we send you a gift? Yes, we can. Now let's see. Oh, we're so close. This opinion of us is higher, but... Whatever, let's just hire them on for now. For the piety. I wish that they would offer take the vassalization, but whatever. And let's go to... here with them. Trade him personally, of course. And with that momentous occasion, we're going to end this episode here. So thank you guys for watching. We have finally restored the Kingdom of Israel and the High Priestdom of Judaism. So, thank you for watching. Please like, comment, subscribe. It really helps the channel grow. And I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching. Bye.